Hi, Alex here from Rebelloper.com, and in this episode of our Advent Calendar tutorials, I am going to show you how you can add a countdown label. That is correct, we are going to add a countdown label to a SpriteKit game, so let's get started. Now, before I continue setting up our project for the countdown label, let me just show you how you can download all of these awesome Christmassy backgrounds. Well, I have added a Dropbox folder, and you can find the link in the downloaded resources. So go ahead and click the downloadable resources and download all of these, and you will find here a backgrounds download URL pages file, where inside you will find the link to the Dropbox folder where you can download all of these awesome downloadable backgrounds. Now that you know that, you can make your background Christmassy. So let's get started and let's see where we left off in the last episode, where we have created a score and a best score logic to store all of these inside our user defaults. Well, let us just, as usual, commit, and let's add the message day 11, push to remote, and I will just commit this one file. And now we are going to create a new branch from the current branch as day 12. Yes, we are at the half of our Advent Calendar tutorial, and today we are going to create a countdown label. So let's go ahead and select our gameplay.swift file, and let us create an SK label node. So that will be named, let's name it var. Okay, it will be of type SK label node. And now let's initialize it. Okay, what do we want to add in here? Let me just scroll this up so you may see better. Okay, we want a label, and it will be an SK label node, and we will choose font named, and the font name is, as you remember, we found out the font label name inside our BD button, and it is, if you just scroll down here, a bubble gum. Okay, I'm just copy this out and I will paste this in. Okay, good stuff. Now let us just add, let us just first return our label so we get rid of this missing return in a closure error. Okay, let us just hit command B and everything should compile successfully. Okay, now let us add a font size for this label. So, and universal font size. And if you don't know what the universal font size is, go ahead and check out my previous video on how to create this universal font size. So I would just add it here, let's say 20 for an experiment. Okay, next up, let us add a label, a Z position, and let's see what kind of Z positions do we have here. Well, not any. So I will just, well, we have our button here to go back. I will just add a Z position of 2. Okay, so we may see this button. So we may see this label. Next up, let us just add a color, and it will be an SK color, and I will just simply add a white. Next up is horizontal alignment mode equals to, let's say, horizontal alignment mode to the center, or maybe better yet, left, because we are going to add this score label to the left of our screen. Okay, let it be left, and label dot horizontal, not horizontal, vertical alignment mode, and this should be center. Okay, center. And I believe we are ready to add our countdown labor. And of course, in as usual, in the did move to view. So let's type here countdown label dot position, and I will just add it just below the back button. So I just copy out this CG point and paste it in here, and I will add the screen size height to be 18%. Okay, and finally, let's add our child, add child, and countdown label. One thing that we might add here is the text, because of course now we don't have any text, so we just add, let's add here a variable for, and this will be, let's say, a zero. It will be an integer, so for now we will just set the countdown. Well, let's set the text inside our setup here. So label equals to, and I would like to add here counter, and I will just type it out, but for that to be recognized we need to add lazy var. So we need to, let's set it up like just so. Okay, and let's build and run and see if that, oh, we need to of course set it as a string. Now that we have taken care of that, let us just build and run and see if a zero appears on the top left corner of our screen. Of course, in the gameplay scene. So let's just wait for it. Here we are in the main menu scene. We just take care of that music and we are transitioning. Yeah, we already have implemented our chart boost. So if you recall, we did not have a chart boost appear. Now some time has gone by and now we do have a chart boost interstitial appearing on our did tab. Okay, and here it is. Here is our score label. Okay, that looks pretty good. Okay, let me just make this font a little bit higher, like 34, maybe 36, and let me just take this a little bit down to be 75%, and I believe we are ready to go. Let's just build and run again, and next up we are going to make this counter decrement from, let's say, 60 seconds, let me just go here, like 60 seconds, and then go to 59, 58, 57, and so on till the zero. Okay, and now just make this 79. Let me correct this. Okay, so what do we need? Well, we need a timer, and for that we are going to declare our counter timer here, and it will be a simple timer. It will be a simple timer. And of course, we need some sort of a constant to check what is the highest level, so 60 seconds or 90 seconds. So we need to add our, let's name this, and that will be, for now, let's add it to 60 seconds. Good stuff. Now, after we have added our countdown label, we need to start our counter. And I will just copy this out and create a new function down below with the name start counter. And this is fairly easy because we are just going to schedule our timer. So type in counter timer. I will just name this counter timer, not time. Okay. And it will just type in timer, schedule, and we will choose this schedule with interval, and which should complete with a block, or maybe just let us just choose this with the selector because we want to fire a function here. So schedule timer, time interval, that will be 1 second. Okay, target is self, of course, and the selector pound selector, and I will create here decrement counter. And let me just copy this out and create our function here with the same name, decrement counter. User info should be nil, and repeats, of course, it needs to be true because we are decrementing our counter on each and every second. Now, good stuff. And as you can see, we have here an error, and to fix this, let's just fix it. And as you can see, we have added our objective C before our function here for the decrement counter. Okay, and what do we need to add here? Well, of course, we need to set our counter to be minus equals 1. So we are decrementing our counter. And of course, we need to update the text of our counter label. So add here counter a countdown label dot text equals to, and interpolation and counter. Now, one last thing we need to add is set the counter's start value to be the counter start value, of course. And that will be under the start, before the start counter. So, because we are using our counter here to be counter start value. Okay, good stuff. And now let us just build and run and see our countdown value decrease from 60 seconds to 0. Okay, as you can see, we had a little glitch there because for 1 second there was a 0 at the countdown value. So first things first, we need to change our text label to be countdown. Let me just copy, it would be much easier, counter start value. Okay, and now we should start with a 60 on a second one, and that is it. 60, 59, 58, and that will go through till 0. And I will just point out our next episode's scope, and that is what happens when we go out of time. And I will just change this to 6, and I will show you what happens, and we will fix it in the next episode. Here is our chart boost, of course. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0, and the game should end, but it counts down to minus 3, minus 4, and so on till the end of time, or till the end of our life cycle of our app, till I hit this stop button. Yeah, we have stopped it. Okay, let's change this back to 60, and I will see you in the next episode where we will tackle this issue, and we will tackle another issue. What if this counter start value is more than a minute, like let's say 90 seconds, then it should be displayed as 1 minute and 30 seconds. But we will talk about this in the next episode. So go ahead and share this video if you liked it with your friends, and go ahead and give it a thumbs up, and subscribe to our channel if you want to see more videos of me talking about these iOS stuff. Okay, I will see you in the next one.